Hello, sixth graders. This video is being made to help you with your IXLs this week. Yesterday, we took notes on how to cite a source. How to cite a source will help you when completing N.1. So these are all in your notes from yesterday. This video will help you with N.2 and N.3, even though N.3 is actually called Identify and Correct Plagiarism. I think it says new at the very beginning, but I'm going to call it N.3 just to keep it simple. So N.2 is all about in-text citation. What that means is you are giving a citation within the text, meaning within your paragraph. You're giving credit to an author. And then N.3 is plagiarism. Plagiarism is when you take someone else's work and claim it as your own. You cannot plagiarize because that is illegal. So that is what these two IXLs are about. In the next few slides, I have screenshots of actual IXLs that I will explain that will help you understand them. So, moving on. This is an example of N.2. Right here. N.2. So, what you need to do is add an in-text citation using MLA format. That means that you need to give credit to the author within your text. So, like if you're writing a paper, within your paragraph, you give the author's name and the page number from which you got their information from to give them credit. So, for example, when you do an in-text citation, you always look at the source. You need to see where is this coming from. So this sentence, most visitors to Denali National Park come during the very popular summer season. The source of this sentence was from Denali by Tom Kleins, page 66, published in National Geographic, February 2016. So, when you do in-text citations, there's two things that you need to focus on, and that is the author's last name and the page number. So what you would type in the lines here is you would type in parentheses. Let me make my pen smaller so you can see that a little better. You would write in parentheses. Or type in, then you would type in the author's last name, Kleines, and the page number, which is 66. So I would do a space, 66, and then the end of the parentheses. This, sixth graders, is how you do an in-text citation, where you have the author's last name and the page number in which you got this information from. Here's another example. Same thing. Here is another sentence. It is easy to grow vegetables and raise beds for several reasons, including good drainage. And as always, we need to look here to our source. Who wrote it? It looks like it was written by Johanna Silver. So we have her last name on page 62. So in the response box, I would type in a parentheses, and I would type in Silver, S-I-L-V-E-R, space, 62, end of parentheses. Now, IXLs is very picky, so if you do not capitalize the author's last name or do not put a space or misspell the last name, it will mark it incorrect. So make sure you are just being very attentive as you complete these ones. So this is how you do N.2. Moving on to N.3. This is Identify and Correct Plagiarism. So it says on top to read the following text from the Vikings, Northern Warriors, by Thor Odinson. I like that name, Thor. I've never heard of anyone called Thor besides in the movie Thor. Anyway, this is the original text right here, okay? So we have this here as the original. And then below, at the bottom, is a student used information from the text above to write a report about the Vikings and their battles. Select the sentence in the student's report that plagiarizes the text above. That means they copied Thor's work, and they did not give Thor credit. So in this case, when we're looking at what was plagiarized, The very top sentence, the Vikings' success in battle was largely due to their weapons, is the exact same sentence that this student used to end their paragraph. The Vikings' success in battle was largely due to their weapons. So for these ones, sixth graders, you are just identifying which sentences are plagiarized. So which sentence from a student's work do they copy exactly from the source? Because we know that we cannot just copy something exactly word for word. So if this was actually IXL, I would click this bottom sentence right here. And then I would hit submit, and that is the plagiarizing Thor's work. The second part of this IXL, because there will be two questions per passage, once you click here, the next question will ask you to now complete the student report with a sentence that avoids plagiarism. We don't want to plagiarize. So here are our options. Thor Odinson says that the Viking success in battle was largely due to their weapons. So in this case, yes, the student uses the quotation marks to do a direct quote, but they don't direct quote the whole thing, only the due to their weapons part, where realistically, the whole thing should be in parentheses. So I know for a fact that this one is not it. So I'm gonna just put an X there. The next one says, Thor Ordison suggests that the Vikings' success in battle was largely due to their weapons. Well, in this case, they give the author credit and they put in quotation marks exactly what the author says. So in this case, yeah, that looks right. And just to check to make sure that I am correct, the bottom one says, according to Thor Odinson, the Vikings' success in battle was largely due to their weapons. Yes, that's right, but there are no quotation marks to give a direct quote. So in this case, this one is also not correct. So this middle one is how you would correct the plagiarism. If you have more questions on your IXL, sixth graders, please don't be afraid to ask me. I would love to help you.